Hi and welcome to our video. We are making flubber today. It goes by a few names: flubber, gack, slime, whatever you want to call it. It's cool stuff. It's gooey, stretchy, slimy, bouncy, and frankly kids just love it. So to make that, we're going to use borax, Elmer's glue, and water. Those are really the three ingredients. You can also use food coloring. So you'll want those items and then some measuring devices as well. So for this recipe, we're going to use an 8-ounce container of Elmer's glue. This is just the regular Elmer's glue. We're going to dump that whole thing into a glass bowl. Once we have that container drained out into the bowl, we're going to just take some regular water. We're going to fill up the container all the way. We're going to put the lid on. We're going to shake it up, get some of that glue off the inside. We're then going to dump out really ultimately all the water into the bowl, but I like to do an increment. So we're going to do half of the bottle, and then we're going to put the lid back on. We're going to shake it up a little bit more, and then we're going to dump the rest of the bottle in, which will leave us with 8 ounces of glue and 8 ounces of water in the bowl. So after you are done with that step, this is a good opportunity to then put in your food coloring into that solution. If you'd like to use food coloring, adds a little more fun to it. We're just going to do a couple drops, which is just going to barely make it a purplish hue. But you know, it is kind of fun, more fun than white. So Austin is now going to get the borax and mix it with some water. So the ratio is a teaspoon of borax into a half cup of warm water. And that's going to be separate, in a separate solution than the bowl with the glue and water. So I have Olivia stirring the glue and water, and Austin is putting in the 1 teaspoon borax to the half cup of water. So he's going to stir that up, and he's going to stir up that water and borax until the borax is diluted where you can't really see it anymore. And once you have the glue and water stirred and the borax and water stirred, then you can start adding the two solutions together. And I like to do this in increments, like increments of, you know, maybe 3 steps. As soon as you put that first bit of water into the water and borax into the glue solution, you can quickly and immediately see it start to take effect. And what it's doing is it's changing the molecular structure of the glue molecules and causing them to bond and create these chains, and makes it kind of stringy and elastic. So really kind of cool to see it change right before your eyes. So it takes a little while. It takes about a minute or two of stirring and adding the borax water solution. Once you've added all that solution and you've stirred it for a little bit, you're going to get to a point where you're probably going to just want to go ahead and ditch the spoon and start using your hands just to finish up that last part. So really just start massaging the goo ball, the flubber, which really it's almost a finished product here. I start massaging that and then just rub it around in the solution and water and just work it all in. And you know, this is the part that's really the most fun. The kids finally get to touch it. And what's cool is if they're fighting over who gets to touch it and fighting over massaging it, hey, it just makes it go faster. So Livy and Austin are doing great. They almost have it done. I mean, you can see it's pretty much done. There's hardly any liquid left. It's interesting stuff. I mean, it's squishy, it's stretchy, it's slimy. If you push on it, it kind of hardens up a little bit where you could make it into a ball and bounce it. But if you hold it and just let it dangle, it'll stretch real long. If you pull it quickly, it breaks in half. Definitely interesting stuff. The kids just go nuts with it. So from that batch, you can see we got quite a bit. I mean, we have, what do we have, about 20 ounces of it. If you factor in that half cup of water plus the 8 ounces of water plus the 8 ounces of glue, Now that's a lot of flubber. So that's going to last you a while. You're going to want to get some Ziploc bags to store it in. And then, you know, when they play with it, of course, if they don't get it all nasty and disgusting, then it's going to last a lot longer. As long as you don't let it dry out and you keep it fairly clean, they will be able to play with it for quite a while. So hope that video helps. Hope you guys have fun doing this at home.